Let's talk about how to find the current declination in your area. As you know, your compass needle points in one direction and the vertical lines on your map point in another direction. Technically, this is called the grid magnetic angle, but for this video, to keep things as simple as possible, we'll call it the magnetic declination. As you'll also probably know, the magnetic North Pole keeps moving around, and this means that the amount of magnetic declination changes continually. On some maps, there may be something printed to say what the declination was at the time that the map was printed, and also an estimate of how much the map maker thought that it may change each year to help you work it out. But for some reason, let's say that we've decided that we don't want an estimate. We want to know what the exact declination is in our area for certain. So this is one way that you can find out. Let's say that you can see a ground feature off in the distance, and you can identify that feature on your map. And importantly, you're confident that both your location and the feature's location are accurately shown on the map. What you do is you take a bearing, a compass bearing, to the feature, and you'll get a magnetic bearing of, say, 1, 2, 3. It's called a magnetic bearing, by the way, because you're using the magnetic needle in the compass to take that bearing. Then, using your compass, you also take a bearing from the map, from your location to the feature. You can see that you've got a grid bearing of 1, 4, 3. Oh, it's called a grid bearing because you're using the lines or the grid on the map to take the bearing. So now we have two bearings, a magnetic one and a grid. And here's an easy rule to remember. If the grid bearing is greater than the magnetic bearing, your declination is east. Have you got that? If the grid bearing is less than the magnetic bearing, your declination is west. So in this case, we've got a magnetic bearing of 1, 2, 3 and a grid bearing of 1, 4, 3. So the difference is 20. And as a grid bearing is greater than a magnetic bearing, your local declination at the moment in your area is 20 degrees east. How simple is that? But you don't have to believe me just because I say it. The next time you go out with a map and a compass, give it a try for yourself. I would say, seriously, that you should never believe people when they say something on social media. But hold on, you'd have to believe me when I say that you shouldn't believe me. How does that work? I don't know. It's actually always been the case, you know, in the media, which I would describe as any form of mass communication, someone asking you to believe what they're saying. What on earth has this got to do with declination? Nothing. Whatever next. Shakespearean waffle in a video about magnetic declination. I really, really need a plan for these videos. I know, I think I actually need a director, someone to tell me what to say and also what not to say, to cut out all the waffle. Anyway, I hope you now understand how to find the exact local declination in your area. Thanks for watching.